What I remember about my sister Becky, my much older sister Becky, is Cora Ice was our neighbor, and she would walk down to our house once a week and give Becky private piano lessons. We all had to huddle in the kitchen, and Mom had to bribe us with food so none of us would make a peep while the two would practice together. Eventually, about the age of 16, she decided to learn how to play the organ, and Mr. Hull essentially gave her the key to the organ at church and let her practice herself, and she's essentially self-taught. About the age of 19, Becky decided to buy a full dual keyboard organ with a full set of pedals. Our living room was little and we already had an upright piano in it, and now imagine my mom and dad letting her put this gigundous organ in our living room. Becky chose to buy this organ before she even bought herself her first new car. In 1974, Becky started playing at the Flat Rock Church. And then about Valentine's Day in 1975, she took over the position at St. Peter's in Florida, where she has been all these years.
Well, even growing up, she had been playing the organ for how many years, and she still practiced and practiced.
I remember being woken up every Sunday morning early to the sound of Mom playing in the parlor.
Way too early.
On Easter morning, when we had to be 6 o'clock sunrise, she's probably practicing at 4 in the morning.
Mm-hmm. And who did we have to sit with?
Dad. Yep.
Dad. A lot of Sundays with Dad.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of Sundays with Dad.
But she used to get so mad when she'd be playing at the beginning of the service or the end, and you'd come up and ask her a question. I'm playing!
Mom,
it's important.
And I can't remember Mom missing a Sunday ever. And for any sort of funeral, wedding, or anything like that, She always tries, it usually involves us, but she usually tries to make each of those special in some sort of way.
We always have fun at choir rehearsals and when we perform for function. Becky makes it fun. That's just Becky. She never tires of going over parts with us to make sure that we get the song the way it should be sung. We altos always tell her that she's picking on us because we have to practice our parts so often. And those tenors, they're always perfect. But we know she wants us to harmonize nicely. She has complete confidence in us and very patient with us. There was one time we were practicing in the choir loft and there was a bat flying overhead around above us. And we women were all running around, scandering around, trying to get the closet behind the organ, falling over each other. Becky beat us to the closet and closed the door. We women stood there. We were ducking our heads and waving our hands over our head, trying to keep the bat away from us.
I climbed up on a bench because I thought I could bat it down, but we couldn't. And so that was the only time I ever stood on the church bench, that's for sure.
And I imagine if anybody would have walked in at that time and seen us up there, they would have thought we were practicing a spiritual. It took us a long time to get Becky convinced, though, to come out of that closet.
Many times, Charlene and I were asked to sing solos or a duet at a funeral or, once in a while, a wedding. Becky always made herself available with time for us to practice, and she knew just which songs would fit our voices. Pastor Cornelius was heard to say once, "I never worry when Becky is playing that the words or the music won't be acceptable, liturgically or theologically, I'm sure." We all have persons that we consider to be our mentors, and usually they are people who are older than we. Becky has been a person that I look up to and admire immensely. Her musical talent has been a blessing to so many of us, and to me especially. I'm so thankful for God's blessings through music, especially when we are planning, when we are praising Him through hymns of praise and all to His glory. Thank you.
We're proud of you, Bob.
Very, very proud.
Say it nice.
Very, very proud.
You're the favorite. You might as well say it.
I am the favorite. What hasn't already been said, though? Well, we just want to say thank you, Mom, for putting the music in our hearts.
In our souls, in our minds.
In our minds. Congratulations, Mother, on 40 plus 1 years of playing organ. And we want to thank you for bringing us up in a Christian household with music in our everyday lives. Yeah, thank you.